NHL preseason action continues. Winnipeg Jets and Edmonton Oilers here at Rogers Place. Scarboza turns it over, and the shot from Malone is blocked by Michael Hutchinson. Ryba goes for Darnell Nurse in the long shot. Spacek plays it for Patan and for Roslovic. A bit of a knuckler scramble, Talbot down. And he holds it out back for Byfuglien. In it goes, Roslovic drills another one, and that one over top the net. Patan controls off the sideboards to the front of the net for Lemieux. Rebound, Spacek scores. Michael Spacek opens the scoring on the power play.
What I liked about this is Patan on the half wall, the left-handed shot on the right side controlled everything, and this is the scenario that he wants to be in. We talked about him in the open, quarterbacking this power play. Played a lot of second power play unit minutes last year, but he gets the puck to the net. I thought the Jets did a real good job with puck retrieval.
Gets it for Tucker Pullman, on for Scarboza. At the line, Lemieux couldn't handle it, shot score! Benning let it go from the line, it went off somebody in front of the net.
Well, I thought the Jets were doing some pretty good exits and getting the puck to safe areas while they were under pressure in the zone. But there's the turnover, a shot to the net, and you're right, Puljujärvi gets his second of the preseason. Coming into tonight, has one power play goal, an assist, and five shots on net. A real headsy play to go to the net front.
So the Oilers tie the game up 1-1. In front of the net, loose puck score! Brad Malone. The Oilers win bang-bang at Bell MTS Place in the first meeting, and they go bang-bang here in the opening period here to take a 2-1 lead.
Byfuglien just rims the puck, and off the half wall here, it goes to the middle. Hutchison probably should have been a little bit more on his toes, but he's respecting the crease because he knows Malone, off of a redirected puck into the slot, is close by lurking.
Winnipeg Jets end of the ice. Patrick Maroon goes in after it. Shot, save made by Hutchinson, scramble, McDavid trying to find his own rebound, can't.
Good defensive job on the penalty kill by Edmonton, cutting the ice in half.
Long stretch pass by Byfuglien to Lapon, and that shot scores! J.C. Lapon!
It starts with Hutchinson, and a good job by Lapon. Right there, what a good look we have there. Lapon on his horse. That first shot goes off the pipe, the rebound comes to him, and a good job by Lapon. Following the shot up to the net, he gets a fortuitous bounce, I agree, but none of that happens if he doesn't have a great shot initially and follows it up to the net to even this game at two.
Spins it up the boards for Morrissey. Morrissey for Pullman, 15 seconds in the power play. Back for Morrissey, tees it up, doesn't shoot it, Pullman will. And off a stick or a skate and a glove save.
Morrissey's a swift skater, capable in both ends of the ice, and Pullman, it allows him to get his legs going up.
McDavid with a stride scores! Connor McDavid with that speed, and the Oilers have the 3-2 lead.
Watch how his feet cross over, even when he's skating in straight lines. That's what gives him that explosiveness to blow by defenders, and what speed that was as he cuts in and slides that in through the five-pole of Hutchinson to give his team a 3-2 lead here, just under 3 minutes into the third.
Nice up on for Lemieux. Lemieux for Tanev. Tanev, the rebound, scores! No, they're waving it off.
Well, we've got a goaltender interference challenge here on the goal from Paul Maurice, and you'll see in the replay that Lemieux dishes the puck, and then here's the bump coming from Nurse right there. Gives him the nudge that Maurice feels was the interference call that forced Lemieux into Max Talbot. There's another look at it.
After review, the decision on the ice stands, no goal penalty.
Off the backboard, score! Well, there's Puljujärvi helping his cause to stay with the Oilers.
Well, Hutchinson has had to deal with a couple of weird bounces tonight on goal number two as well, but there's the dump in off the backboards, and it almost double skips out to the middle of the ice, and Puljujärvi going to the net, and that's what coaches will always tell you.
At the line for Jones, deflected, good left pad save, rebound, score. Brad Malone has his second of the night.
He does a little stutter step to get the puck to the net. He finds a lane, and the rebound ensues. Malone with a quick stick. Here again, Jones waits, puts it to the net. A rebound that comes off that left foot of Hutchinson right to Malone. He sticks with it, puts it back of the net for his second of the night.
Throws it for Stroman, back for Benning, back for McDavid. Trying to get it to the goal line for Jujar. Kara scramble, score! Bounced around. Puljujarvi might have another one.
Puljujarvi jumps on the opportunity to get his second of the night. You see Jujar Kara there with an no-look shovel backhand pass. It's an ugly one, but it counts.
Icing gets waved off, and the fans here in Edmonton appreciative of the effort they have seen from their team here, especially in the third period, with four unanswered goals, and Edmonton will win it 6-2.
Well, the Oilers certainly got better as this game grew. Two goals from Puljujarvi, two from Brad Malone. The Jets 2-for-7 on the power play. Svachek gets his first. And this is the final audition for this Jets team to give what they have to the coaching staff. They'll be making significant trims tomorrow to the roster, and we'll see what's left over for Monday against the Flames back in Winnipeg.